Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope everything is going great. Today I am going to talk about inside and outside of integrated amplifier from Marantz, which a newly released model 10 published August 30, 2024. The model 10 is an integrated amplifier designed from scratch using the latest technology and the highest grade part. It is a dual monosymmetrical fully balanced class D amplifier with fully separated pre-amplifier and power amplifier and separate power supply circuit. Output is 250 watts and 500 watt per channel into 8 and 4 ohms. I am going to explain each part to you in detail. Check it out. Line input voltage power. The main input voltage AC line filter circuit describes frequent high frequency wave from being sent back into the power network, and it protects connected equipment from power line disturbances and surges. Toroidal transformer for pre-amplifier. The analog power supply circuit for the preamplifier includes equipped with a toroidal transformer with a dedicated copper plate shield. Analog power supply card. From the toroidal transformer instead is fed to the analog power supply circuit for preamplifier. Basically, this is a power supply circuit consisting of diodes and two capacitors each of 10,000 microfarad, 35 volt. Left and right phono equalizer card. Two preamplifier blocks are for signal amplification for phono MC and MM. Here the signal is amplified to get a certain level so that it is sufficient to be fed to the power amplifier. There is an additional card that stands vertically above the main PCB. Marantz calls it HDAM, which is basically the same as the operational amplifier circuit. The main pre-amplifier on the Marantz Model 10 is to regulate the audio gain of the pre-amplifier recorded line 1, line 2, balance 1, balance 2 power amplifier input. There is operation high quality audio volume handled by IC Music 72323. Let's take a look at the internal of the first layer of the Marantz Model 10. The left and right channel of the power amplifier board are similar. The power amplifier section is equipped with a uniquely designed dual monosymmetrical class D power amplifier, which was developed in collaboration with Amplifier of Denmark. The power amplifier circuit is configured with BTL bridge transformerless connection using a bridge circuit. There are two kind big components in the circuit, are inductor and capacitor. All of them are low-pass filter circuit because the carrier wave shape digital is no longer needed, because what will enter the speaker is only the amplified audio signal. Let's see how many amps of current are consumed on one channel. 5.6 ampere per channel and 11.2 ampere two channels. The output voltage result is 44.7 volt RMS and two side and 22.4 volt RMS on one side. The left and right SMPS power supply are for the left and right channel of the power amplifier respectively. So, this is very different from amplifiers in general. Generally, amplifiers only have one power supply, and this does not apply to the Marantz Model 10, For its power amplifier, it uses two power supplies. In each power supply, there are four electrolytic capacitors with a value of 2200 microfarads, 50 volt. And we should measure the dimension of this Marantz model 10 with high depth. 440 by 170 by 422 mm. FCBS, another feature, is the Model 10 is also compatible with FCBS floating control bus system. It's the high quality sound system for link control between multiple Model 10 units up to 4 units. Each unit is controlled via its ID number registered beforehand. Once registered the ID numbers, the unit will enable link control operation, such as input selection, volume control, on-off selection, off-muting, display, etc. The front panel is made of machining aluminum up to 45 mm thick to reduce the negative effect of vibration on sound quality, while the side cover is made of 15.8 mm thick aluminum with a design that hides all screw from the front to the sides. Marantz Model 10 implements 2-pin male chassis socket. Why not the usual 3-pin with grounding? Why not implement socket like this? This is all because the Marantz Model 10 is equipped with this ground terminal. On the other hand, in BIM mode, as shown in the diagram above, one channel of input signal is sent to both the L and R channel of the Model 10. The same audio signal is output from the left and the right terminal speaker. In this case, the Model 10 responsible for L channel is responsible entirely for the L channel, including the preamplifier. The same is true for the R channel, and L and R channels are completely independent. This is called complete BIM. The quality of this was amazing. Thank you for watching.